Dear students, welcome to the science class. Right, we started with the topic known as motion. In the last class, we studied about the relationship between the speed and distance. That is nothing but we studied about the relationship between distance and time, as well as we studied about the relationship between velocity and time, and we also studied about the relationship between position and time, as well as position and velocity, and we derived these some equations regarding those three topics. That is nothing but relationship between position, relationship between time and velocity. That is nothing but that can be given as v equal to u plus a t. If you remember the previous class, v equal to u plus a t. In the same manner, we derived the equation s equal to u t plus half a t square. That is nothing but the it is the relationship between position and time. In the same manner, we derive the equation as b square equal to u square plus 2as. It is the relationship between the position and velocity. And also we discussed about the numericals which are going to come in this topic regarding those relationship. In the last class we solved one numerical. In today's class we are going to solve further numericals which are given in the textbook as well as in the text question. So one by one we are going to see. Now first question, that is nothing but example 8.6. A car accelerates uniformly from 18 km per hour to 36 km per hour in 5 seconds. Find first question the acceleration, second question distance covered by the car in that time. Right, first question is nothing but a car accelerates uniformly from 18 km per hour to 36 km per hour in 5 seconds. Find the acceleration as well as we have to find out the distance covered by that car to get that acceleration or to attain that acceleration. So that before solving the problem, we have to understand the problem. What they are asked? They asked for the acceleration. If you remember the previous class, acceleration is nothing but the it is the change in the velocity to the time, or it can be say that rate of change of the velocity. It is nothing but acceleration. So they have to find out the acceleration. What we required initial velocity as well as required final velocity. When you see that problem, a car which is changing its speed from 18 km per hour to the 36 km per hour, it is moving with the speed of 18 km per hour to the changing its speed for 36 km per hour. That means initially it is moving with the 18 km per hour. So that 18 km per hour is nothing but our initial velocity. In the same manner, at last it is moving with 36 km per hour, it will be final velocity. Time taken for the change in that velocity is nothing but how much? It is equal to 5 seconds. So that one by one we are going to calculate acceleration as well as total distance covered. So that first we have write down given. Now what is given? We are given initial velocity. We are given initial velocity. That is nothing but how much? It is equal to 18 km per hour. That is nothing but u equal to 18 km per hour. That is given in the problem statement. The same manner, final velocity. Initially, car is moving with 18 km per hour. Suddenly, it changes its speed to 36 km per hour. 36 km per hour is nothing but the it is the final velocity of that car. That is nothing but 86 km per hour. Right. The total time taken for the increment of the speed from 18 km per hour to 36 km per hour is nothing but how much? It is equal to 5 seconds. So that time taken can be given as time taken. That is nothing but t equal to how much? It is equal to 5 seconds. Now what we have to calculate? We have to calculate the acceleration of the car. Acceleration of the car, that is nothing but a equal to question mark. In the same manner, second question is nothing but we have to calculate the distance covered. We have to calculate the distance covered. That is nothing but what? It is equal to s equal to what? It is equal to question mark. S equal to question mark. So that one by one we are going to calculate. First we have to calculate the acceleration. so that we know that what is the formula for the acceleration, that is nothing but a equal to v minus u divided by t, that is nothing but rate of change of velocity, right? So that when you check that before solving this equation, we have to check the SI units of the given data. When you see their time taken is in second, but speeds are in kilometer per hour. It is also in kilometer per hour. It is also in kilometer per hour. So that what we have to do, we have to convert these speeds into meter per second. If you remember the last class, to convert these into meter per second, we have to multiply with 5 divided by 18. So that 18 into 5 divided by 18, 81 that is equal to how much? It is equal to 15 meter per second. Initial velocity is nothing but how much? It is equal to 5 meter per second. Sorry, it is equal to 5 meter per second. In the same manner, when we convert this thing, it will be 36 into 5 divided by 18. 18 ones are 18 twos are 25. How much? It is equal to 10. Therefore, it is equal to 10 meter per second. Final velocity in meter per second is equal to how much? It is equal to 10 meter per second. Initial velocity is equal to how much? It is equal to 5 meter per second. When we substitute both the values in this equation, we are going to get the acceleration. So they are a equal to what is final velocity? 10 minus what is initial velocity? 5. What is the time taken for the change in that velocity? This is equal to 5 seconds. That is equal to divided by 5. Therefore, a equal to 10 minus 5 is equal to how much? 5 divided by 5. 5 comes out. 5 comes out. Therefore, it is equal to 1 meter per second square. It is equal to 1 meter per second square. Always remember, try to write the, all the assignments which are coming. Assignments gain marks. There is, if you don't write the assignments, they are going to not give, going to give you any marks. Therefore, a equal to 1 meter per second square. Therefore, a equal to, that is nothing but acceleration of that car is equal to 1 meter per second square. Now, second question. We have to calculate the total distance covered by that car to attain the acceleration of 1 meter per second square. If you remember the previous class, we have two equations to find out the total distance covered. That is nothing but s equal to ut plus half at square. Right, that is nothing but s equal to ut plus half at square. Again, we have an equation that is nothing but v square minus u square equal to 2as. V square minus u square equal to 2as. So then it's up to you which equation you are going to follow to solve that equation. So then I'm going to use the equation that is nothing but s equal to ut plus half at square. S equal to ut plus half at square. I'm going to use this equation. When you see that u is given, s it is there. T is given, s it is there. Time taken is also given. A we find out a is nothing but 1 meter per second. T it is also given, so that we can use this equation. As well as we can use the equation that is nothing but v square equal to u square minus plus 2as. In that equation also we are going to find out the s. That value is also going to be find out by that equation. It is up to you. Try to solve that this numerical using that equation. I am going to solve by using this formula or this equation. So that what is u? U is given in the problem statement, that is nothing but 5 into what is time taken? Time taken is given as 5 plus half. What is a calculated one? What is time taken? 5 over meter square. Right. That equal to 5 5 25 plus 1 into 1 1. 5 square how much? It is equal to 25. 25 1 side is equal to 25 divided by 2. Right. We have to find out the LCM. So that LCM will be how much? 2. If you find out the LCM, it will be into 2 and it will be into 1. So that 25 2 is how much? It is equal to 50 plus 25. That equals how much? It is equal to 75 divided by 2. 75 divided by 2 is equal to how much? It is equal to 37.5 meters. It is equal to 37.5. We'll check the all the exercises. Those are in meters, so that the eternity of the distance covered will be also be meter. Therefore, S equal to how much? It is equal to 37.5 meters. That is equal to how much? It is equal to 37.5 meters. Now we can say that the acceleration of that vehicle or car is equal to 1 meter per second square. Total that acceleration the car is moving with to cover 37.5 meters. That is nothing but after 37.5 meters distance covered in 5 seconds, the acceleration of the car is 1 meter per second. That is nothing but the car is going to change its speed from 18 km per hour to 36 km per hour in 5 seconds after covering 37.5 meters of distance. Right? So that we can write in here. After completion of the problem, we can write acceleration of the car is 1 meter per second square and distance covered by that car, total velocity car is 37.5 meters. Now we are going to take on next second question. That is nothing but the brakes applied to a car produce an acceleration of 6 meter per second square in the opposite direction to the motion. If car takes 2 seconds to stop, after the application of the brake, calculate the distance traveled by it during that time. That is nothing but a car is moving. Car is already in motion. To that car, brake is applied. When the brake is applied, the acceleration of that car becomes 6 meter per second square. 6 meter per second square. After the application of the brake, after 2 seconds of the application of the brake, car is going to stop. If the car is going to stop, we have to calculate the distance covered of that car after the application of the brake. So that if we take that car, the car is moving in this direction. Let this be the car. Right? We don't know its initial velocity. The car is moving, that means it's having a velocity. That velocity is that it will use. Right? The person is going to apply the brake. When you apply the brake, what will happen? The car starts to move fast or it's going to start move slowly. The decrease will be there. It starts to decrease its speed. So that brake applied will be making the resistance force to that car. It is opposing the motion of the direction of the motion of that car. So that after 2 seconds, this car is going to be stopped here. This car is going to be stopped here. Stopped here, that is nothing but it is going to come in the rest position. After how many seconds? After 2 seconds. With an acceleration of 6 meter per second square. A moving car, when applying a brake, it is going to stop after 2 seconds. And the acceleration of that car is 6 meter per second square. What we have to calculate? We have to calculate the distance traveled from this point to this point. So that we can write given data first. What are the given data? First, acceleration of the car. Is equal to A equal to how much? 6 meter per second square. 6 meter per second square. Second time taken is equal to how much? It is equal to 2 seconds. Right. Now, the car is moving with an initial velocity. We are going to apply the brake. After 2 seconds, the speed of that car is getting reduced. After 2 seconds, exactly 2 seconds, the car is going to stop. Stop is nothing but it is going to become in the stationary position. that is nothing but at rest position. If it is at rest position, what will be the speed of their car at the rest position? If the speed of the car of that car at the rest position, what will be that speed? If it is at rest position, there is no chance of the motion of that car. If there is no chance of the motion of the car, that means the speed will be how much? It will be equal to how much? It will be equal to zero. That speed is nothing but what will be that speed? If it is going with the initial speed, at last it is going to stop, that means final speed. Last speed is nothing but the final speed. Therefore, final velocity of the car will be final velocity of that car. At last it is stopping, that means it will be equal to final velocity. That will be, that is nothing but V. Now what will be equal to? If it is starting, if it is stopping, there is no motion of that car, that means it will be equal to how much? It will be equal to zero. That is nothing but 0 meter per second. Now to calculate the distance covered, that is nothing but distance covered. That is nothing but distance covered. That is nothing but S equal to question mark. To calculate the total distance covered by that car after the application of the brake, what we require? We require the initial velocity of that car. With which velocity it is moving, we require the initial velocity of that car. So that we have to first find out the initial velocity. We have to find out the initial velocity. That is nothing but U equal to question mark. When you see the formula for the S, that is nothing but S equal to ut plus half at square, as well as S equal to, that is nothing but V square equal to u square plus 2 es. When you see the both the formulas, there is a requirement of initial velocity. So that first we have to find out the initial velocity of that car, right? So that distance covered, S equal to question mark, initial velocity u equal to question mark. So that we know that, we know that A equal to U plus, right, sorry, B equal to U plus 18, if you remember the formula. Therefore, U equal to 1, U equal to 1, B minus 18, B minus 18. For that reason, we have to find out first U. This is the relationship between the distance, velocity and time. So that we using this formula, we are going to calculate the initial velocity. Right? I hope this is clear. But when you check all the values are in meter per second, it is also in second, it is also in second, so that we can easily calculate the initial velocity. But in the problem statement, they told you that a car accelerates uniform, the brakes applied to a car produce an acceleration of 6 meter per second in the opposite direction. In the opposite direction. If it is applied in the opposite direction, if you remember the previous classes, while studying about the acceleration, I told you 2 points. That is nothing but acceleration and deacceleration. Acceleration, if there is a speed, increase in the speed, it will be known as acceleration and it will always be in the positive. In the same manner, deacceleration is nothing but reduction in the speed of that vehicle or object. Reduction of that speed of vehicle or object can be given as negative if the speed of that vehicle is getting reduced. If that speed of that vehicle is getting reduced, it can be given as negative. When you check the problem statement, a car is already moving. The car is moving. After the application of brake, it is getting stopped. It is getting stopped. That means the speed is increasing or decreasing. Speed is decreasing. Velocity is decreasing. If the velocity is decreasing, acceleration can be given as minus. Acceleration can be given as negative. Why negative? The acceleration is in the opposite direction. It is in the opposite direction. That is nothing but the speed of that vehicle is getting reduced. The speed of that vehicle is getting reduced. For that reason, we should take the acceleration as minus. Why? It is in opposite direction. It is decreasing in the speed. From some speed to the, it is becoming 0 meter per second. For that reason, always remember, any acceleration, that is nothing but any decrease in the speed, will be how much? It will be in minus only. It will be negative only. I hope this is clear. why we have to take it as negative value? Because it is in opposite direction, or it is a reduction in the speed. So that by using this formula, we are going to calculate the initial velocity. That is nothing but u equal to what is v? V is nothing but 0 by the problem statement minus in the bracket. What is the value of acceleration? That is nothing but minus 6 into what is the value of time taken, which is equal to 2. Therefore, u equal to minus into minus how much? Minus into minus plus 6 to the 12. That is nothing but 12 meter per second. Initial value, initial velocity is equal to how much? It is equal to 12 meter per second. Next, what you have to calculate? We have to calculate distance covered by the car after the application of the brake, so that we can use the formula. That is nothing but s equal to ut plus half at square. S equal to ut plus half at square. Right. Therefore, s is equal to what is your? We already find out that nothing but 12 meters per second. That is nothing but 12 into what is time taken for the distance covering. Time taken in this problem is equal to 2 plus 1 divided by 2 into what is acceleration? It is equal to minus 6. It is equal to minus 6. Time taken is equal to 2 whole bracket square. Right? That is for how much? 12 2 is 24 into 1 by 2 into minus 6. 2 square is equal to how much? It can be written as 2 into 2. 2 square can be written as 2 into 2 or equal to 4. 2 ones are that equal to 24 minus, sorry, it is plus 1. Plus into minus, it will be minus 6 to how much? It is equal to 12. 6 to 12. 24 minus 4 equal to how much? It is equal to 12 meters. Therefore, s is equal to 12 meters. The vehicle is going to travel 12 meters after the application of the brake. So then we can write the answer as what is that question? After the application of brake, car takes the car travels 12 meters after the 12 meters after the application of the brake. After the application of the brake, to stop, car is going to travel 12 meters after the application of the brake to stop, and the initial velocity of the car is nothing but how much? It is equal to 12 meter per second. 12 meter per second, the acceleration is given as 6 meter per second square, which is in the opposite direction. For that reason, we are going to take it as a negative value. I hope this is clear. Next, we are going to see the third problem. That is nothing but a bus starting from a rest. A bus starting from a rest moves with a uniform acceleration of 0.1 meter per second square for 2 minutes. Find the speed acquired. The speed acquired by that bus. Second, we have to find out the distance traveled by the bus to attain the acceleration of 0.1 meter per second square for 2 minutes. In the problem statement, they are given that a bus starting from a rest position. That is nothing but it is a rest. That is nothing but the motion of that bus is a nothing. That is equal to initial velocity. That is nothing but if it is a rest position, if there is a no motion, then the speed of that bus will be how much? It will be equal to 0 at initial point. Right? After the rest position, it starts to move. After the rest position, it starts to move with an uniform acceleration of 0.1 meter per second. With an uniform acceleration of how much? 0.1 meter per second square. For how much time? For 2 minutes. For 2 minutes, it is going to continuously travel with the acceleration of 0.1 meter per second square. If that's so, we have to find out the final velocity. That is nothing but the speed. speed acquired after 2 minutes will be what? It will be final velocity of that bus. It will be final velocity of that bus. In the same manner, we have to calculate the distance traveled after 2 minutes. So there we first we have to solve this question. So that first we have to write the given data. Given data is nothing but initial velocity of the bus is equal to how much? Initial velocity. That is nothing but u equal to how much? It is equal to 0 meter per second. Why? It is at rest position. That is nothing but the speed will be 0. In the same manner, final velocity is not given in this problem statement. So we have to calculate the final velocity only. And the acceleration of that bus is given. Acceleration of bus, that is nothing but a equal to how much? It is equal to 0.1 meter per second square, which is given in the problem statement. And the same way, time taken is given. Time taken by the bus is equal to how much? T is equal to 2 minutes. T equal to 2 minutes, that is equal to how much? It is equal to 120 seconds. If you calculate it, only 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds, for 2 minutes it will be 2 into 60, that is nothing but 120 seconds. Why we have to convert these things? We have to convert these things because it is given in the meter per second, it is also in the meter per second, so that should be in the seconds only. So then what we have to calculate? We have to calculate the final velocity. That is nothing but v equal to question mark. Right, as well as we have to calculate the distance covered. That is nothing but s equal to question mark. If you remember the relationship between what? Relationship between time and velocity, that is nothing but v equal to u plus at. We have to find out the final velocity. So then answer for the first question, that is nothing but this will be the first and this will be the second question. That is nothing but v equal to u plus at. That is nothing but v equal to what is the value of u? U is 0 plus a. What is the value of a? That is nothing but 0.1, which is given in the problem statement. Time taken is 120 seconds. If you multiply these things with 0.1, v is equal to how much? 120, 0.1 sir. It will be equal to 12 meter per second. Final velocity of that bus will be 12 meter per second. Now what we have to calculate? We have to calculate the total distance covered. So therefore we know that s equal to ut plus half at square. S equal to ut plus half at square. That is nothing but u is equal to how much? It is 0. Time is equal to how much? It is equal to 120 seconds plus 1 divided by 2. What is the acceleration of that bus which is given in the problem statement? It is 0.1 into time taken, which is given, which is equal to 120 square. 0 into 120 is equal to 0 plus 1 divided by 2 into 0.1 into 120 can be written as 120 square can be written as 120 into 120. So then 2 1s are, 2 6s are, 60s are. Right. Therefore, it will be 0. Therefore, 0.1 can be written as 1 divided by 10. It can be written as 1 divided by 10 in the fraction value. It will be 120 into, it will be 60. 0 0 get cancelled. 12 6 is how much? It will be equal to 720. 12 6 is 72. 0 0. That will be equal to 720. Therefore, s equal to 720 meters. That is nothing but the speed of the bus. The speed of the bus is 12 meter per second and the total distance traveled by that bus bus is 720 meters. 720 meters. I hope this is clear all about the numericals. In the next class, try to solve the numericals in text questions which are given in the page number 109 and 110. So that in the next class we are going to solve those numericals again. Up to that point, take care. Thank you.